Fleming.
And I'm John Krasinski.
I'm on the scene with Chase at the world premiere. This is the world premiere?
Yes.
Oh yeah. My God. You can finish it.
Happy birthday, Chase.
Yes, this is birthday. Double
yeah.
digits.
Yeah. Hey, guys. It's me, Chase. And there's nothing imaginary about this. We're on the scene in New York City for the world premiere of If. Our friends at Paramount Pictures have invited us out to the red carpet for this highly anticipated, imaginative, and hilarious movie.
I'm an if. Get it? Imaginary? Friend?
It's about a young girl who goes on a magical adventure to reconnect forgotten imaginary friends with the kids who have forgotten them when she discovers that she can see everyone's ifs. And not only are we here to celebrate the premiere of this movie, but I'm celebrating turning a year older. Because today is my 10th birthday. Imagine that. And what a party there's gonna be here tonight, because there are some huge stars about to head down the purple carpet, and I can't wait to meet them. And I'd love it if you could join me, so come on, let's go. Right now, I'm with Blue. So, Blue, what was it like being in the movie?
It's a magical kind of movie that I think will really captivate people.
It was really fun.
It is really funny. It is very heartfelt.
I'm here with Ryan.
Hey, Chase, your birthday?
Yeah, it's my 10th birthday.
I couldn't tell. You weren't. You know what you need to get? You need to get like a huge button that you put on your jacket that says it's my birthday. If you could. Oh my God! What is happening? I had no. I spoke it into existence, I guess.
Do you guys have imaginary friends, or did you guys have imaginary friends when you guys were growing up?
I didn't have one, but he did.
I sure did. I had an imaginary friend named Sam Brace, because when I was 8 years old, I wanted to have braces. I thought braces would be super cool. Turns out they weren't as comfortable as I thought they'd be, but it was really, so what we did is we walked to a video store to go see movies, and on the way there and back, we used to pretend we were in movies. So we were in action movies, comedy movies, horror movies, we ran away from werewolves.
Did you have imaginary friends when, like, you were growing up at all?
I had a bunch of little dinosaurs, and sometimes they were bigger, so I could play with them in different places, but sometimes they could just fit in my pocket, or they'd ride underneath the car, hanging onto the bottom of the car. Yeah.
Wow, that's really amazing, honestly. Do you think adults could have imaginary friends?
I think adults need to be put in touch with their imaginations when you get so bogged down with your mortgage and your taxes. It's very nice to know that there's another garden in the back of your head which belongs only to you.
Do you have any imaginary friends?
It's a tiny monster.
What types of things do you, like, do with him? Do you play with him and all that stuff?
We do dance together.
Do you think, like, adults could have imaginary friends nowadays?
Yeah, I don't see why not. I don't think they need to come to the workplace, but I think, yeah.
Did you ever have, ifs growing up?
My brother had an if, and I had a friend, a neighbor, he had an if, which was a crocodile that used to jump up and bite the moon.
Do you think nowadays that kids don't have imaginary friends because of devices?
I'm not sure. I've seen a mix between it. Like, I'd say it's pretty even, like 50-50.
How was it like playing in the movie?
It was a great experience. Everyone was nice. I loved it. I love everyone who I got to work with.
What character did you play that in the movie?
I played someone named Jeremy, who's having a really bad day.
Yeah, so you were Blue's kid, right?
Spoiler alert, but yeah.
My character's name is Bee. She's 12, and you're turning 10. Pretty close. She's kind of going through a tough time in her life. She's dealing with a lot of different emotions. And in coping with her emotions, she discovers she has this kind of superpower, and she can see everyone's imaginary friends.
Which character do I play in the movie? I play a guy who has two names, the man upstairs, which is a little ominous, right? Like, who's the man upstairs? What kind of name is that? But he also has a name, and it's Calvin.
I play Cosmo.
Oh, the spy kind of guy?
Yeah, the spy kind of guy.
It's all up to you. No pressure. Krasinski!
What was it like being in the movie?
It was a great experience. It was magical, and it was one of the best times I've had working.
You played the sunflower?
Named Sunny, yeah.
What was it like being in the movie?
It was really fun. You know, John, who directed the movie, John Krasinski, is a really good friend of mine. And so I watched how hard he worked and for how long. It was like 4 years for him to get this movie made. How old are you? How old did you turn today?
10.
Okay, so when you were 6, he started working on this movie. Can you imagine that? So he's been working on it all those years. And I watched how much love and care and heart and soul and energy he put into it. And I'm just proud to have a little part in it and to support him because the movie is beautiful.
And what was more difficult to work with? The big star actors, like the big name actors, or the or the ifs?
That's a really good question. I gotta say, she made it so easy. She's not only one of the best actresses I've worked with, but she's a magician. Because you know what? When you watch this movie, if you're a kid, you think, wow, I would really like to be her. And if you're an adult, you go, oh my God, she's my invite to going back to being a kid. This person is a superhero.
Starting to see why I live alone.
Chief!
Kind of a kid creates an invisible if.
Who was more difficult to work with? The imaginary friends or the, big name actors?
Oh, the big name actors are the worst. Oh, the attitude, the pomp, the circumstance.
Oh, I thought you were going
to
say...
to makeup.
I thought you were going to say Keith.
No, it's disgusting. Keith is disgusting as well, by the way. I appreciate his restraint, never showing himself and never speaking, but he tripped me many times and I did not like that.
So the ifs were harder to work with.
Which if? Keith?
Keith.
He's the worst.
Yeah.
Yeah, I tripped over him this morning when I was doing my intro.
Did
yeah.
you really?
Yeah, I was like, come on, let's go. And then Keith,
okay, well.
Yeah.
You tripped over Keith?
He's yeah. the worst.
He's
Keith, come on, man.
He's,
that's so rude.
Yeah, he's annoying.
I'm blue.
But you're purple.
My kid. Well, he was colorblind.
So you're colorblind in the movie, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are you colorblind IRL?
I'm not in colorblind in real life. Do you like my blue suit?
Yeah.
No, I didn't. Yeah. That's why, that's in the movie, he calls him blue, but he thinks he's purple, but he calls him blue.
I like your purple suit.
Thank you, that's why I wore it.
So, in the movie, I know you like dancing, but are you actually, like, do you like dancing, and could you dance for us right now? Oh, what do you think the main message of this that, like, kids and adults should take away?
I would say that it's really that, like, kids are often in a real hurry to no longer be kids, right? Like, do you sometimes think, I can't wait to be a grown-up, or I can't wait to be, you know, this or that? And then sometimes grown-ups are like, I wish I was still a kid. So I think just getting a little piece of each in both sides would be something very important. Well, John Krasinski, who's the director, I think you've met him, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's great. So he really did a beautiful job of showing us the magic in between being a grown-up and being a kid. And that's what this movie does, I think, and it's really wonderful.
Movie's amazing, by the
Thank
way.
You, guys. Thank you
yeah.
so much.
I already watched it. What's the message of the movie?
For me, it's about the fact that children should be reminded that they have the power of the imagination in their mind to do anything, to see anything, and to redeem the adult world.
Keep your imagination going. Dream big.
The message is, even if you're an adult, you can still remember what it was like being a kid.
Well, that's gonna do it from the world premiere of If here in New York City. I never could have imagined having such a fun time talking to the cast and crew from the movie, and I'm so glad you could join us for the fun. If you enjoyed this video, please show your support and give it a like, subscribe, and share with anyone you know who grew up with an imaginary friend. Remember to gather up all your friends, real and imaginary, and go see If when it comes to theaters on May 17th, 2024 from Paramount Pictures. Trust me, you'll feel like a kid again. On the scene from the world premiere of If, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Come on, Blue.